Well, the COVID-19 outbreak definitely impacted in the management of our patients with multiple myeloma, but it's important to put in context that the COVID-19 pandemic has been quite dynamic. This means that in March and at the beginning of April, our situation was critical, and during these weeks, we decided to maintain the treatment of patients with multiple myeloma only in those cases in which we consider that the treatment was necessary because the disease was active and there was not any other possibility. But in the rest of patients, we decided to maintain the oral treatment if possible at home in order to avoid the probability of infection as much as possible in patients with multiple myeloma. But once I've said this, today we are now visiting our patients almost in a normal way. And during this COVID-19 outbreak, important to remark that our main objective was to protect our myeloma patients from becoming infected by COVID-19. But at the same time, our main objective was to maintain the disease under control. Otherwise, we were going to have two problems, COVID-19 and multiple myeloma. And for doing this, we decided to optimize the circuits of the patients at the hospital, trying to reduce as much as possible the time of the stay at the hospital. And we prescribed the treatment in advance. And when the patients arrived to the hospital, they were directly to receive the treatment, but our main objective was to maintain the disease under control because we considered that this was our main objective. This has been the plan we've done here in Salamanca, in our hospital, and I have to say that the outcome of patients with multiple myeloma in the COVID-19 pandemic has been quite good. It's true that some patients finally became infected by COVID-19. Definitely, the mortality rate for myeloma patients has been higher than the normal population. But we had tried to maintain our patients at the lowest risk as possible of becoming infected. And I think that we achieved this objective because most of our patients were receiving treatment according to the current guidelines, and not many patients were finally infected by COVID-19.